This is a follow-up video about one of the most interesting devices of this year so far, the LD2410 presence sensor. This sensor is super sensitive even to hardly noticeable movements, and it is natively working with Home Assistant. First of all, in case you don't know, presence sensors are devices that detect movement and presence of people or moving objects in certain area. They are commonly used in lighting system, HVAC system, security systems and other applications where it is important to know whether someone or something is currently available. What's different in LD2410 sensors is that they can detect even the slightest movement like human breathing, and that is because a new and different technology than the regular passive infrared sensors is used. Also, these sensors are super cheap. You can get one for less than $5 in AliExpress. But be careful which version you are choosing. Do not get the regular LD2410 sensor, as it is not having a Bluetooth support. Instead, go for the LD2410B or LD2410C sensors. The first one is much smaller. It looks like the regular version, and it is having very tiny pins, where the second one, that is the LD2410C, is a little bit bigger in size and it have a regular sized pins. These sensors are not battery powered, and to power them up you only need a USB cable that you are ready to cut. Then you have to connect the red and black wires from the USB cable to the VCC and ground pin on the board. And that's it. You now have a great presence sensor. And I will leave some affiliate links in the video description if you want to make one or more for yourself. Anyways, once you have the sensor and once you connect it to a USB port or power it up using an USB power adapter, the sensor will be automatically detected by Home Assistant and you can start using it in a variety of home automations right away, so you can make your home smarter. Speaking of Home Assistant, feel free to join my webinar where I'll talk about the official ways to get Home Assistant, plus one secret way to get started on a PC in under 5 minutes. And here comes the fun part. One of the frequently asked questions that I got after my first video about these sensors is how to get distance sensor working. That's easy. Once the sensor is added in Home Assistant, by default only the motion and occupancy sensors are visible. If you want to also show the detection distance sensor, for example, or some of the other distance sensors that are available, you just have to enable them from the Home Assistant menus. Some of you are complaining about connectivity issues and that the sensor is becoming unavailable in Home Assistant after some time, and that only full restart of the system resolves the problem. I want to say here that my LD2410B sensor is not having such issues at all. So I guess it all depends on the Bluetooth receiver that you're having on the device that is running Home Assistant. Also, the distance between the sensor and the Bluetooth receiver, and are there any obstacles between these devices. Also, try to shorten the distance between the devices temporarily and check if there are any differences. To upgrade the firmware, you have the following options. I'll open my App Store on my iOS device and I'll search for HLK Radar 2. This is it. I'll click on Get to download the app. I'll authenticate here. The same process is valid for Android devices, so if you have Android, you should search for HLK Radar 2 in your Android store. I'll open the app now. Make sure that device is connected. LD2410B or C is connected to a powered USB port. So I'll click on the first found device. The default password is HiLink. I'll enter it. You can change that password, and it is a good idea to change it afterwards. And this is the app interface. Here you can see whether movement is detected, as you can see, as well as the detection distance. And if you click on the More button, you see all of the settings from where you can change the password and from where you can update your firmware. If I click on the Details, I can see what this update is all about, but in Chinese, unfortunately. So I'll go back and I'll tick this, and then I'll click Upgrade. And current version is 1.07 and the latest version is 2.04. So I'll upgrade this. I'll not close the app and I'll keep my phone close to the sensor in order not to interrupt the updating process. And the upgrade seems to be complete. I'll confirm this. And I'll connect again to my device. If I go to the More button again, that's the settings. And if I click on firmware version, I can see that I'm already with the version 2.0 for something and I don't need further upgrade. One of the great advantages of the LD2410 sensors over the traditional PIR sensors is that they can detect movements even through some obstacles like curtains or thin walls. For example, I have a Shelly Motion 2 sensor in my camper and this sensor cannot detect if someone is moving on the front driver or passenger seat when the curtain is down. But this is not a problem at all for the LD2410B as it can detect movements through the curtain, which is perfect for my use case as I want privacy and security at the same time. I have to admit here that until now I had 2 or 3 false alarms for several months of non-stop operation from the LD2410B sensor. And because of my configured home assistant automations during these false alarms, I received a message and a phone call in the middle of the night saying that movement in my camper is detected, which overall is not very pleasurable experience. However, I investigated in details the first of these false positive alarms thanks to the security cameras that I have installed around my house, and all the leads are going to a street cut. So, for the second and third alarm, I just checked the cameras and then I returned back to sleep. Overall, both the LD2410B and LD24C are great presence sensors that offer same features and capabilities with just different form factor. It all depends on your specific preferences and requirements regarding the size of the sensor. Grab my smart home glossary for free, which is full of useful explanations of the most common smart home words and abbreviations. The link can be found in the video description and on your screen. I'm Kirill, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.